Hello and welcome everybody to Three Points of Light. I am one of your hostesses, Mama D, also known as Arlene. And our other co-hostess this evening is Jennifer's Journey. Say hey, Jennifer.
Hey, Jennifer.
Uh-huh. And oh, look, our adorable little Brian has got his mic on. Hey, Brian. Oh, God. Brian, how you doing? You can talk. I've unmuted you. Oh, well, maybe he's not talkative. All right, well, maybe he'll come and chime in when he's ready. And our guest this evening is Terry Marie. Now, I've known Terry for a little while, but you tonight, sweetie pie, are Jennifer's guest. So say hello, Terry.
Hello, beautiful Jennifer, and hello again, Mama D.
Jennifer, Terry is in your good hands.
Okay. Well, tonight we have Terry Marie, the Angel Lady, with us. And first I want you to tell us all the new and exciting things you have going for 2017. I know that Mama D and I both have joined your new group, and I'm all excited about that. I love my angels. So if you could start out with telling us about what you are going to be doing for the new year 2017, I'd appreciate that.
Thank you. I will tell you as much as I've been told thus far. They don't tell me everything, which is probably a good thing. One of the things that we did, I guess, towards the end of 2016 in getting ready for this brand new 1 year is to change the focus of the Facebook group, which was about the Intuitive Summit. It is now Angels for Success and Prosperity. Who doesn't want more of that, right?
Exactly.
Another piece that we're working on, which is how you and I got connected with this particular interview with you two beautiful lady souls, is we are hosting an interview series. It's Success and Prosperity Mastery. I went back and forth for a while on calling it Angels For or leaving the angels part off because I wanted to include different facets or areas of entrepreneurs and businesses, and not everyone is like us who are angel-centered or angel-focused, right? You know, even though they're maybe on their spiritual path and whatnot, you know, like learning about bios and lessons learned from other areas and other spiritual entrepreneurs was more important than putting it in this instance, Angels For, because that would really limit it. And what else are we working on? Our next book, Mama D, Angels for Success and Prosperity, Raising Your Inner Vibration, Attracting More Opportunities, Clients, and Financial Prosperity. And hopefully the cards will be done this year. We'll see.
Yay.
Yeah, well, for the Sacred Angel Realms. Other than that, it's pretty much business as usual. Thank you. And just following guidance. You know, that's pretty much what I do.
Okay, Jennifer has this habit of muting herself even though she's...
Yeah, my poor elbow. And how long have you been doing this, Terry?
Full-time, 6.5 years. Before, I think it's about total of 14 now, before I really started coming out of what I call the spiritual closet, because I worked for a government agency down here on the southwest border, and I didn't really want anyone to know what I was doing,
okay.
Because it might have interfered with my employment, you know? So
right.
They're kind of touchy about that stuff.
Okay, and now, okay, like you said, we all follow our own spiritual path.
Mm-hmm.
What was it that made you decide, well, I'm usually it's spirit given, but what was it with, you know, the communication with the angels that you knew that this was what your path was to lead you to?
In the beginning, beautiful, it was more that I stopped trying to be normal. I made a conscious decision to stop trying to fit in at all costs, because it wasn't working, and it hadn't been working for most of my life. Somewhere when I was younger, and I don't remember how young, I just turned off everything because no one in my family was like me or I wasn't like them. And being in a military family, it's not always that easy to be other. So I turned the other off. And I think about 15, 16 years ago, I started to turn it back on. And I found one of Doreen Virtue's books, or maybe it found me, Earth Angels, that real small pocket book, pocket-sized book. And I think I read it like two or three times during a weekend. That was the conscious start of my connecting to angels in a way that has led me to being here and now. I remember one time being on an air flight from El Paso, Texas to Austin, and the turbulence was really rough. I mean, even the attendants had to sit down and things were bouncing around. And I hadn't even told anyone, probably not even myself, that I was really connected with angels in this way. But I just sat there and I closed my eyes. And to myself, I remember saying something like, "Angels, please calm the air and deliver us safely to our destination." And within, before I even finished the prayer, in my inner sight, I saw these two huge angels, one on either side of the plane, as if to part the turbulence, and the air just immediately calmed down. There was a little bit there, but not like it was, and you could just feel the energy in the plane just, woof, I mean, it just came down. People stopped freaking out, and things stopped bouncing around. So that was one of those things, and it just led from there. I started an aromatherapy business, and the more I focused on trying to learn things, the more I was started to receive blends without really even knowing that much about the oils themselves. And I'd write them down, and then I would do what I was guided to do. I knew it was coming in because I was trying so hard to focus over here, and everything was coming in over there. So, you know, then I go back later and check, and I go, "Wow, this is really cool." You know, it kind of started that way. And from there, I took tarot reading classes and mediumship and Reiki, and, you know, I just dove in the deep end, 11 classes in 1 year, in addition to my regular 45-hour a week job. Does that answer your question, Jennifer?
Yes, it does. Now, so this is what you're doing full time. You're not working anything else. This is what you're doing full time.
That's correct.
And this is working very well for you. I myself am trying to get started in my, my spiritually based business. For a long time I doubted myself, and you know, I would go back and forth with it, and I'd start things and I wouldn't finish them. But this year is my year. So what would you suggest to everybody that, the beginning, the first beginning processes to really dig your feet in and just go with it? Did I stump you?
No, I'm trying to figure out where the best place to start, because there are so many different levels.
Yes.
It is about, it's more than the manifesting. It's more than the declaring your intentions and your goals and writing out your dreams. It's all part of it. And, yeah, okay, just a second.
Take your time.
Oh, well, I'm actually acknowledging them and I don't even hide it anymore. Let's see. What's the best way to translate the energy into human words? The biggest stumbling block for me for years, even after I had started full-time, and this is 6.5 years ago, being transparent, it took me about 4.5 to figure this part out. So here's a golden nugget, ladies and gentlemen. Watch what you say. Here's an example on myself. Hey, thanks for the new client, but it's not enough. I was focusing on the wrong end of prosperity. I was focusing on the not enough. Mm-hmm. I was grateful. I was saying thank you. I was being genuine. But what I was really doing was negating what was just happened, and I was saying it's not enough. So what was I manifesting?
Not enough.
Mm-hmm. Conscious mind is a tricky little bugger. I call mine Charlie. I hope there's no Charlies ever listening, because there's nothing derogatory meant. And when mine comes up, I say, that was then and this is now. That's another good one, Jennifer, is that was then and this is now. Because the person who tried to do her business in 2016, Jennifer, you're not the same person who is digging her heels in now. And actually, it's more about not even digging in, but taking that leap into faith. That's something that I just started rewording for myself in the last few weeks. I'm not taking a leap of faith. I'm leaping into faith. And most of us have seen that Indiana Jones movie, whatever the one it is, the Holy Grail one, where his father's been shot and he's supposed to go out and step into thin air and he doesn't see any stones or no bridge or nothing. And then he takes that first step because the alternative is his father dies. And yeah. Then all of a sudden, he sees the first stone, and so he picks up a handful of gravel and throws it out there. But only by taking that first step is the rest of the path revealed to him. You have to. It's what see by faith, not by sight.
Exactly.
Because your physical eyes, your conscious mind will lie. It will lie to you, saying that what you see is all there is.
Yeah, and I have actually, that was something, a big phrase I would, I'm going to leap, I'm going to take that leap of faith. And actually, I have borrowed your phrase since I first heard you say it. And I try to stay as positive as I possibly can. And I'm a big one on how you put things out there in the wording. Mm-hmm. I think that's very important. Positive affirmations, what you put out, I do believe you will receive. So I am a big one on that.
So just
may I say something about affirmations? Oh, go ahead, Monica.
Diane, in the chat room, Diane said, so it's all in the wording. It's in the wording, Diane, yes, but it's also in the thought.
And the intention. You got to put your intention.
And the emotions and the energy. It's about being really aligned with your intentions, your agenda, your purpose, your emotions, your energy, your thoughts, your actions. Because we can say things all we want. And affirmations are tricky. They can backfire and bite you in the buttocks. And that's what you're sitting on. Yeah. It can bite you, because what can happen and often happens is we, and I'm going to include myself in this because I used to do it, is I would have a goal for, I recently went to the Tucson Gem and Mineral Show. I literally a week ago, about this time, I was still driving home. So I had set a intention and manifested the budget that I wanted to be in cash, because it's much easier to deal with people from around the world if you have cash because not everybody has the swipey thing, So I had that intention, and then I went about my work, and I didn't say, okay, thank you for this or thank you for that. I didn't say thank you for XYZ number of dollars, because what that actually can do is to trigger the conscious mind, what I call ego chitter chatter, into saying, oh, you think you have that? Let me show you. You do not. And let me show you how much you don't have. So by saying certain affirmations, in that way, it actually backfires, because what it helps you focus on inadvertently is what has not yet manifested, and you actually end up pushing it farther and farther and farther and farther out.
Okay, so instead of saying, we're going to continue using you as your as the example. So instead of saying, thank you for the $20, can you just say thank you, or you just leave it until you're...
Well, see, it's about combining more than one school of thought. Yes, absolutely write down exactly what it is you want. And then you allow yourself to let go of that particular outcome. I knew what I wanted, and I'm being nudged to just go ahead and be totally open here. I wanted $3,000 in cash, and I wanted more than that left in my bank accounts, you know, so I didn't have to worry about the first of the month. And it happened. What I focused on in between there, and we're talking, I think it was September of last year, that I decided this is what I wanted. That amount of money, and that included travel expenses. Now, I'm in El Paso, Texas. It's 5 hours down the road, so I didn't have any air flight. But there are still meals, and there's still hotels, and there's still gas, okay? And they're getting ready. So that was my budget, the whole thing, $3,000. And I kept envisioning, and I took one of the tools from Wayne Dyer's, one of his books. I think it's Manifest Your Destiny, but don't quote me on that part. And he recommended that right as you're going to sleep, you envision or you focus on what it is you want. Well, I had a reference point because I had been to the Tucson Gem and Mineral Show several times. It had been 6 years. So I saw me walking around and choosing or allowing the crystals to choose me. That's how I stayed out of my own way. Letting go of the outcome so that it could actually come and manifest.
And those were beautiful. I saw those pictures. I mean, that was,
I liked
wow.
You
loved it. Awesome.
Thank you.
So you brought some of those goodies home with you?
I did. The intention is to open the Secrets from the Crystal Garden online shop. So it's a crystal shop.
Oh,
and we're
very
in the process of doing that, yes.
Very nice. So,
go ahead.
years ago, you know, I would have thought anybody was crazy if they told me they communicated with the angels like we can and we do. Still to this day, some people feel that I'm crazy when I say I do communicate with the angels, and I do. Do you feel that everybody in this chat room, that they can also communicate with their angels, and can you tell them how?
Yes, it's not for the special few. Everyone can. If you don't believe it, if you doubt it, if you ask for something and then go, yeah, well, okay, they're way busy and I'm not important enough and the white feather I've asked for is probably never going to come, then you're right. All of that. When you start believing in yourself, when you start believing, and I don't mean just up here, the belief then needs to get down to your heart center. There are actually three levels of belief. This is a long way around to answering your question, but this is where I'm guided. This is where I'm going. Three levels of belief. Mental or the intellect, you know, the mental. The heartfelt, which is in your heart center, where that center where you know things, kind of like the claircognizance, that sense of knowing, and we all have had that. From time to time, sometimes for the guys, it's the gut feeling, the gut hunch. And then there's that soul level, that really deep-seated inner, I got it. More than likely, everyone who's here with us tonight or whoever is going to listen at some point has had at least one or two or three of those, I got this. And it seems to be very fleeting because it's not something that we're used to. Either acknowledging, being consciously aware of, or even being in that place of absolute knowing. So what can you do to hear? Everybody hears differently. Everybody talks to them differently. Everyone senses their energy differently. Once had a client, still a client, and she was complaining or wrong word, I got it, frustrated at not being able to talk to the angels. And I said, okay, so what are you doing? What are you getting? And she rattled off this list, signs and nudges and intuitive thoughts and signs along the highway and messages and email and book. And I said, so what's the issue? Well, I can't talk to them like you do. Well, I said, well, that doesn't make what you're doing wrong. It makes what you're doing you. Everyone's experiences are different. There are four basic ways to connect intuitively with spirit, with source, with your angels, spirit guides, ascended masters, whomever, your power animals. Seeing, knowing, sensing, feeling, and hearing. Okay, five. Feeling and sensing can be different because you can feel the energy around you and you can sense it. Those are two different things. How do I communicate with the angels? In all ways. All of them. I've been practicing for a long time, and it's what I do every day. Everyone is going to talk to them or hear them differently. I don't always hear a voice. I sense the energy, and it could be a nanosecond of energy, and yet it can take 20 minutes to explain it. A lot of times when I'm journaling in the morning, somebody else will come through, somebody else meaning some angel, and the handwriting changes. That's talking to them. I mean, it's like a text message, right?
Yes.
We text in Messenger, we text by phone, we text with WhatsApp, we email. So how is it that you're recognizing or open to communicating with your inner intuitive self, your higher self, your angels? Because, beautiful souls, you get to raise your vibration. And the angels don't care if it's about prosperity or a love relationship or financial prosperity, wanting a job. However you're going to raise your inner vibration, you get to clear out your channels and you get to connect with them. It's as simple or as easy as you allow it to be. It really is.
Yes, I communicate with them in every way possible too. I really have been working hard on everything, but I noticed myself with the writing. I write all the time. I'm mm-hmm. constantly got a pen in my hand, and I've been just letting go, and I've noticed that I'll come back and I'll look at something and it's like, I don't talk like that. I wouldn't use those words. That, where did that come from? And you know, but it's awesome. It's just awesome. So, but I feel everybody should tap into, you know, communicating with the angels because it really is awesome.
It is. And if you don't listen the first time, they'll nudge you, and they'll nudge you.
Oh,
sometimes
yeah.
They might kind of push you a little bit. And other times, if you're really not getting it and it's like super, super over the edge important, you'll get whopped upside the head with a spiritual 2x4. Don't let that happen.
Yeah. Yeah, I've had that happen many times. I know there's been too many times that I, you know, started and then I would stop and I'm like, okay, you know, I'll put that off. And it's like, no, you won't. We're going to wake you up at all hours of the night. We're going to be putting signs in your face, all, you know. But I like my type of crazy. And everybody does do things differently. And that
yes.
is okay.
Absolutely.
That is okay.
Everyone, you know, here's an example. People who have been abused mentally, emotionally, physically, all of them. You know, whether it's one way or a combination thereof, even with that parameter, everyone's experience within that and how they got around, through, and over it is different.
Maureen says, you look like an angel. I said, yes, she is.
How about the other one with wings?
Now, did you bring those wings on with you?
You know, no.
No.
That was a bit beyond my budget for the whole show, so no. Best thing is a picture.
Yes, that is just beautiful. And so fitting, so fitting.
Well, thank you.
Yes, that's why I chose the picture.
Are there any more books? Any more books that you're going to be working on soon?
Yes. Well, Angel, we actually have, how many are we working on, guys? The Angels for Success and Prosperity is the next one in the queue. One that has been on, had actually started 3 years ago, but we've been working on other books as guided in between now and then, is Angel Conversations with Angels. And there will be, I don't know how many angels are showing up for that. We have the first chapter done, the second one started. Anyway, I'm hoping that that one will be done by the end of the year. So Angels for Success and Prosperity this summer, when in order to do the conversations with angels, and I'm looking up away from the camera so I can actually access where the information is coming through for me, I'm stumbling over my words because they're all rushing in trying to get through my mouth at the same time, and it just doesn't work real well, not for me, is an encyclopedic angel dictionary. Because in order to do the conversations book, we are compiling a database of all the angels that we find in different books, online, and in different publications, in dictionaries, and channeling information from them into something. So this is, I don't know how long this one's going to be, but there are several books in the works. There is a 365 Daily Angel Messages, which is a compilation of how it all got started about 10 years ago, I think it was. Before there was a business, before there was any of this angel readings or healings or any of it, I started channeling angel messages, sending it out to like 6 friends. And it really started with wanting to be able to balance my Earth Realm job as an executive administrative assistant with Border Patrol and my spiritual growing, my learning, because I had just started to come out of the closet, just to myself, but at least I was stepping out. And it was a real challenge. It was difficult. I was the only female in an all-male environment, which that part wasn't too bad, but that was the first thing. I was female, then I was different. So, you know, I was trying to figure out how to balance, and I found this very small perpetual calendar by Doreen Virtue, and one of the messages on there, I thought, wow, I need to share this with so-and-so, so I sent it to 6 friends, and I left it alone, didn't think anything about it. About 3 or 4 days later, one of the girlfriends that I had sent it to, who was going through her own transformation from the corporate world and all of a sudden being part of the downsize for the company she'd worked for like 13 years, wrote me back and she says, you know, I read that and read it and read it and read it. And I went, oh, okay. So I started sharing these little sayings. Before long, there started to be a little message at the bottom of the message, the quote from this perpetual calendar. A couple weeks later, I noticed that the quote and the message had nothing to do with each other. And I thought, well, I'm still getting okay from friends. Now, mind you, there was no business. I was just doing this because I found it moving. And by the time I stopped doing this day in and day out for 2.5, almost 3 years, there were 300 people getting these daily angel messages. And now they're in a book. Not all of them, but most of them are in one book.
And when is this book coming to publish?
That one's already out, beautiful. It's on Kindle and hardcover. It's 365 Daily Angel Messages, and it's been available since October. October.
Okay. Very good.
Do you have Are all your books available on Amazon or?
Yes. A couple of them are just, or one of them is just Kindle version. Mm-hmm. Because in 2015 of July, the laptop I had died, and what went with it, all of my work from the previous 5 years.
Oh,
so,
no.
Yeah. So that particular book, Inner Balance and Harmony, a meditation journal, is available only on Kindle. There's a coloring journal there who it can go with or stand alone from the Sacred Angel Realms. So there are 4 or 5 different books on Amazon at this time. The coloring journal is only in print because it's kind of hard to color on a Kindle.
True.
You know, that's a little.
Some people in the chat room might try and do it anyway. Remember.
Well, that's fine, but it's only available in print, so.
I am trying
to
find
the link.
How else
can we help you with connecting with angels and or whatever else it is you want to ask?
If there's anybody that has any questions, you can feel free to type it in the chat, and we will get to it.
I am going to go. Hold on. I'm trying to find the link for, which I probably should have done more, but...
If I may, about the Angels for Success and Prosperity Facebook group, we are starting to do live trainings every Wednesday. I can't tell you what's going to be Wednesday to Wednesday because I don't know. But we're doing Facebook Lives, but in that group, we're doing a little bit more in-depth.
Copy. Yes, I suggest that everyone, there's the link. And Terry does the live Facebook feeds, and I suggest that everybody go over there and check that out. Terry, which angels were the first angels that you really started communicating with really strongly?
Metatron, Melchizedek, Mishael, or Michael, as most people know him by,
oh.
Raphael, Uriel, Jophiel, Ezekiel, Nathaniel.
Wow, you had
Daniel.
A team.
Yeah, there's a multitude that comes with me. That's just, once I opened up, it just really started happening. And my friends and clients at the time started calling me the Angel Lady. And it would be 3 years before I even had the guts to put it on a business card, and 18 months after that before I almost became comfortable with it. So it wasn't something I just said, well, I'm just going to name myself the Angel Lady and, you know, poo-poo everybody else. No.
Yeah, and that's funny because we, Terry and I were on a show with Cinnamon Moon, and before I even really knew who Terry was, and I knew that we were going to be connecting that night. I was thinking she was the Angel Lady, and when I looked her up, I'm like, oh my goodness, she is the Angel Lady. But like I said, a lot of people, you know, won't admit. A lot of people are afraid to, you know, admit that they communicate with the angels. But I know I do. I know I've got a strong connection with them. How's the energy been lately for you? I know a lot of people are talking about the crazy energies, and I know I'm feeling it. How are they going for you?
Most often, I do really well with them. Mercury retrograde, which seems to affect, I guess, most of the population of the world, does not affect me in the same way. My electronics are fine. I don't care whether it's Mercury retrograde or Neptune's doing whatever it's doing. I just go about my business in as I'm guided. There are certain poles that will affect, but because of the energy level that I work in with every day, there's less of a pull, And when I notice it for myself, I know that it's really got to be dragging other people. And it's not a, I'm a better than. I've just been working in this particular energy, and the angels have so many different filters around me and keep raising my own energy on purpose every day so that I can be more of who I came here to be, to help even more and more people, who in turn get to help even more and more and more and more. So it's kind of like that pebble. And it's more of an intuitive guidance as to what I post about energy. I don't understand the astrology. People have explained it to me, and yet it goes right out as soon as they're done talking to me because it's a whole different vibration than what I work with. And so I get Taurus and Virgo and Libra, and but that's not where I work. So it doesn't affect me in the same ways. It still does. Right. The full moon can be very challenging for empaths. I am highly empathic. On a scale of 1 to 10, pick a number, Jennifer.
7.
12, see? And when I ask people that usually people are in between a 1 and a 10 for their energy level, the angels tell me I'm at 35.
Wow.
So that gives you an idea of where I am most of the time. I've learned how to be more grounded in the last couple of years because it's real fun and real easy to just stay in that other realm. I mean, it's more love, and it is only love, and it's only light. So why would I want to be down here? Well, you know, so to speak, right?
Interesting. Yeah, what I don't was get your the astrology first... either, so go ahead, Darlene.
What was your first book that you read?
The first major publication was Inner Balance and Harmony, a meditation journal for healing, inspiration, and I don't remember the rest of it. They give me the titles, and I have to write it down 100 times before I remember something. I literally do not memorize anything, nothing I teach, nothing. In a reading or a mentoring session, if my clients don't write it down, if it's not being recorded, it's gone.
Yeah,
I just don't remember.
The full title is Inner Balance and Harmony, Angel Messages for Healing and Inspiration.
Thank you.
I found the Amazon page.
That's the first one. It's actually been translated into Spanish, and that's available only on Kindle.
Oh, nice.
Okay.
Oh, the angels are saying that for everyone who loves crystals, you can connect with the angels through crystals. Crystals are a different vibration and frequency, and they can help you tune in to the higher realms. Even those like carnelian and smoky quartz that are good for grounding. When you ground that excess energy, whether it's positive or negative, you can then raise your inner vibration so that you clear your channels of receiving intuitive guidance in however it comes to you. It could be on a billboard that just all of a sudden sticks out at you when you're driving down the highway that you may have seen 100 times, but it hits you in such a way, you go, got it. That's your message. You can get messages through the TV. I was recently teaching a couple of classes, Angels for Success and Prosperity, 60-day intensive, which is interesting because it didn't give me all of the curriculum that I was supposed to be teaching in this. I'm like, okay. And I got one of the segments from some movie I still haven't seen, Rules Don't Apply. I think that's the title of a movie. And what we turned that into was Rules That Don't Apply, and it was a whole week's worth of content and action steps. So you can, if you're open, and I mean really open, and believe that you're special enough, because you are, that you will get guidance and messages and intuitive nudges when you least expect them and when you ask for them. But you have to be open to it. And start saying thank you. And here's something else. If you're not sure it's a piece of guidance or intuition or intuitive insight, ask. The angels don't mind if you ask for clarification. They don't mind if you don't remember their names. There are thousands and hundreds of millions of them. I've got techie angels and copywriting angels. I don't know their names, mm-hmm. but they don't get all PO'd at me because I don't know. And I ask them for help. Say, okay, help me.
Exactly. In the chat room, we have a short question. I have a feeling it's not going to be a short answer. It's from Diane Jane. She says she read somewhere that angels are from the fairy realm. Do you believe that?
If that is the information that someone received, then that is the information they received. In my understanding of things, this is not how it works. The fairy realm is a different vibration. Angels have 9 different frequencies. So there are 9 angelic realms. 3 realms or hierarchies within 3 different heavens. Let's see if I can remember these off the top of my head. Heaven of form, which has the angel, guardian angels, archangels, and angel princes, or principalities for some. The next is the angels of, gosh, you've got the book, darling. I don't.
The angels of creation.
Thank you. And then the last one is the heaven of paradise.
Yeah. Which consists of the angels of thrones, the cherubim, and the seraphim.
Seraphim being the highest vibration. Fairies are, thank you. I'm getting some different words here. They have their own heavenly realm. They are a lower, I don't want to, see, this is where the human language is very limiting because there are 9 angelic hierarchies. One hierarchy has a higher vibration than the other. Doesn't make guardian angels lesser than, it's just a different vibration. So the fairies have their own realm of vibration. It is denser than the guardian angels. The guardian angels are easier for us to connect with because their energy is closest. It's not close to ours, but the closest to us. The seraphim are the highest vibration. And am I saying you can't ever connect with them unless you're like really up? No. It is more of a challenge because our human crap gets in the way.
Yeah. And I don't think she wanted to use the word lower, Diane, because it wasn't what it was. It's not that. My description for the fairies are they are the angels of the earth, whereas the angels, mm-hmm. archangels are the angels of the heavens.
Yes.
So there's
the
angels.
Lower in the sense just, of vibration, but not less than or better than yeah. or any. It's nothing derogatory, not at all.
Okay.
Right.
We have a question from Leo. Now, let's see if I can read this before somebody types and moves it. you say that everyone can connect with angels, but what if you feel really uncomfortable with angel energy? I don't really think there was... Whoops. Somebody did it. I don't really think there was a real question in this per se. I just don't know... I just know that when people talk about angels, I get uncomfortable feelings, and I don't think it would be something I'd be uncomfortable with. It seems it's like a light energy. I feel more comfortable with animals, especially my spirit and power animals, as well as setting general intentions. Anyone without any one specific entity helping, per se, I suppose. I feel I'm rambling, so now with that, ramble away, Leo, ramble away.
So anyone can connect. If you're uncomfortable, then that's going to block the energy. If you're more comfortable with the animal kingdom and your power animals, then work with those because they will give you the guidance and the intuitiveness that you seek. See, the whole part about being spiritual is everyone has their own path and their own unique way. The realm of spirit, fairies, power animals, totems, angels, spirit guides, they do not care who you go to. So long as you go and you're open to receiving. A lot of my clients, not all, but a lot, come from a background religious background, and I am a spiritual child of the universe, so I don't I was lucky enough not to be brought up in organized religion, so I don't have that to let go of. Some of my best friends practice Judaism and Catholicism, and some call themselves recovering from, and you fill in the blank, because I'm not about to disrespect anyone and their beliefs. It is all inclusive. Mm-hmm. And for many, angels are just for the select few, or they're afraid of letting in the dark energies. Set an intention that only those beings, power animals, spirit guides, ascended masters, angels, source, whomever, set an intention that only beings of light and higher vibration and love are allowed into your aura, into your energy, into your life. And then when you feel those ugly things, because, you know, as strong as the light side is, there are people on the dark side who are just as adamant and just as powerful. They can't get in unless you allow them. Now, the caveat for that, or the exception to the rule, is if you are having a down day because, you know, the physical body does get beat up energetically, and it can get beat up from the inside as well as the outside. So in those instances, when you feel something around you that you're not comfortable with, you can tell it to you. And I'm going to use the words they're giving me because this is not my usual language, and they're just saying get on with it. You can tell that thing to get the hell out of here. It's not wanted. And there is a saying, I'm a Bible person, but I think there's something close to get thee behind me, Satan, or something like that. And mm-hmm. somebody correct me if I'm not like anywhere close, but you can tell that entity to leave. They cannot stay where they are not wanted. You can call in whoever you choose to help protect you from negative energy, to keep you safe. And this is something that I do every night as I'm going to sleep, and if I'm awake long enough and I get through the whole list. But if I'm awake long enough, here's what I do. Thank you. I don't ask anymore for an angel to do something in this manner. So when I'm going to sleep, except for copywriting or writing the book or something like that, you know, please help me with. And then I get out of the way and I just start writing. And every night when I go to sleep, thank you, Archangel Mishael, for clearing and removing all negative energies, entities, and attachments from within and around me. Thank you for removing and clearing out all negative etheric cords and attachments from my physical body, all my energy bodies, and my aura. Thank you, Archangel Raphael, for restoring my body to its natural health. Thank you, Archangel Jophiel, for infusing me and surrounding me with your beautiful unconditional love. Thank you, Ezekiel, for transformation. Thank you, Balthiel, for forgiveness. Thank you, Metron, for cleansing, balancing, and aligning all chakra energy centers. And then I get to whatever it is I'm working on, you know, manifesting if I'm awake that long.
Every night. I'm reading what Scott had wrote. It says, I think our own upbringing and faith training plays a part. Like Leo, I get a bit twitchy in conversations like this, but I know a lot of that comes from being brought up in a happy, clappy, we are not worthy type religious fundamental church. But I'm working on that prejudice, laugh out loud. But that's how I felt when I was going through my spiritual awakening, allowing everything to finally, you know, hey, there's no running from this anymore. And when I first started communicating with the angels, you know, I doubted it. And what makes you think you can communicate with angels? But mm-hmm. they proved to me that, yes, I could. And once I really believed and I knew for a fact, there was no doubt in my mind that these were messages from the angels, I was mm-hmm. actually able to start seeing them, feeling them more. Yes, there were times that I would say, you know, if this is truly angels, I want to get that sign. And I would get that sign. And I know I am connected with the angels, and I am not ashamed to admit that anymore. I'm very proud to say that I can, and I do. And, but you have to believe it. You have to believe it, to be able to receive it.
like anything else. So if you're working on manifesting a better job or that promotion or a newer car or a brand new one or a relationship, you have to. Don't like the have to, shoulda, woulda, couldas, but you have to get into that space where you actually believe it's already here. So here's the thing about manifestation. No future tense language. For example, it would be nice if, or I am going to, or tomorrow. You want to put it in present tense or past tense. Thank you for. A friend of mine wanted to go on the trip to Tucson, and it was taking forever to get the permission. He's a nurse who works nights. Longtime friend. So I just kept saying thank you. So I was helping him manifest, but this was something he wanted to do, and I wanted it as well. So I wasn't manifesting something for someone else that they weren't already wanting. And I would periodically in my journal say, I'm really very happy that Ed is going to get to go with me. I get to share the journey this time, share expenses, and probably discover places I probably wouldn't have gone by myself. And thank you for Ed going along with me. And that's all I would say. I didn't go into, I'm so glad that so-and-so said yes, gave me information, blah, 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 because that had not yet been. And what I would really have been doing is feeding the lack, the seeming lack, the appearance of it not yet happening. And the angels are asking me to share with the gentlemen who are talking about being twitchy because of religious background and upbringing. Yeah. See the angels as the messengers of the Lord, because I don't pray to them. I pray with or to them to deliver the messages to Source. So it's not in place of Source, and there are times when I go directly to Source. Nothing wrong with that. There's not a judgment. There's not, jealousy of the angels. You're going directly to somebody else and not to me. They don't care. That's they don't have those human qualities, thank heavens. You know, they're all about pure joy and unconditional love. And it comes and for who you are, bumps, scrapes, bruises, scars, the whole nine yards, just exactly the way you are, that's how they see you. And they love you anyway.
Yeah, that is awesome. Like I said, there were many times I felt very unworthy and, you know, but once I started believing and having faith in myself, trusting everything I got, it just opened the doors. Aw, that brought tears to Diane's eyes. That's beautiful. That's beautiful. Yes, and I cry too. I cry like a big baby, but it's good tears. It's good tears, and those are always good.
Now, okay, hang on. I'm going to bust in here again. We've been at this for an hour. Terry, would you like to take a break? We don't have any music, but you can mute your sound and turn off your camera and go take a break, and I'll sing.
No,
well,
not.
If it's okay with you, I think I'll just leave the settings the way they are. That way I will be sure to be able to get back.
That's
okay.
Fine.
That's fine. And I promise I won't sing, because then that will bring tears to some people's eyes.
Yeah.
Such a nice friend, Jennifer.
We'll be back in just a few moments then?
Yes. Yep,
go ahead, sweetie.
All right. Thank you. The angels and I will be back. I'm not taking them all with me, okay?
Okay. All right, if anybody in the chat room has a question, pop it in. If you don't want to actually ask it out loud, you can put that message to myself or Jennifer. You can do that. And
don't be shy.
Wait a minute. There's not a single person in that chat room that's shy. Okay, well, maybe. Nah. Gigi stole Brian's chair. She's not shy. And Scott, well.
Scott says he is, but I don't believe it.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Oh, okay.
Eric's got a question. Okay, I will copy it down. How rude. Who's rude? There's no rudeness.
Mm-hmm. That is a question. Yes, that is a good, very good question. We'll let Terry answer that. But you know how it came for me? Was I just knew. And if they would give me a set of numbers and, you know, I knew it wasn't a date or an address or something else, I just knew in my heart it was angel messages. And of course I would go to my go-to and it would just resonate so much. Mm-hmm. But like I said, I can, you know, I know the difference. I just know it. Can't explain it, but I know.
Well, I think one of the things, my opinion, when it connects to their angels, their dream team, their higher power, whatever the case is, whereas Terry will call them her angels and Eric will call them, we won't say what his name is. We each have a different name, I think, but it's like, to me, it's like, your higher power. If people can call him God, Buddha, Allah, mm-hmm. whatever. It's still a higher power. Whatever you name them, him, her, there's still a higher power. It's still a higher power. Now, whatever you call them, it's your choice. Okay. Hey, sweetie. We have a question in the chat room. Eric Glynn. He says, I understand that we believe that we are receiving communications from angels. But how do you differentiate between messages from spirit, as in previous souls, and messages from the angelic realm?
Does it matter? As long as that entity
good one.
Is positive energy, and it is not asking you to do something against your own morals, it's different. There's a difference between stepping outside of the comfort zone, which I call the stay stuck zone, because if you're not liking where you are, it's anything but comfortable. So if you're getting guidance, does it matter if it's a previous soul? So, for instance, my grandfather, who has long since passed, helps me with math. Now, I have a very talented CPA who takes care of the big stuff. And when it comes to investing and managing my money on a daily basis, we're trying to figure out things from grams to ounces to pounds. It's like, okay, guys, I need help. I know my grandfather is among those previous human souls who's helping me. Now, I'm not saying I'm getting a formula in my ear, but I am being guided to information that I had before or someplace online to help me figure this out. And once I do, believe me, I'm taking notes. It doesn't really matter where the information is coming from. And if the other question is, how do you discern the difference between the levels of energy? It's a vibration. So, for example, here's, and again, this is not less than or superior or any of those things. It's a matter of degree. Like a rainbow has different colors. The prism, the lower most easily seen is red, and the highest is the violet or the purple. And beyond that, it's difficult for the human eye to see. Doesn't mean other colors don't exist. So, with that being said, we have power animals or totems. We have then, so we have humans, thank you guys. Humans, power animals, spirit guides, ascended masters, angels, and source. Vibrationally higher than the other. Again, not better than, not less than, not superior. Any of those things. It's just a matter of vibration. So, yes, thank you. Previous souls are not angels. The only exception to that rule are two archangels, and they happen to have been brothers at one time, I think twins, but don't quote me on that part. It was Enoch and Elijah, who are now Metatron and Sandolphin, respectively. Those are the only two angels who once walked the earth as human man. And Enoch, whether you believe in reincarnation or not, used to be Thoth, T-H-O-T-H, the initial or original scribe. And when he comes through, I can almost barely read his writing when he's channeling because it's just really messy. And he knows that he's been writing for centuries and millions of years, so he gets a little tired sometimes. But it's not so important. We humans have to label and categorize everything. How about just accepting that the intuitive guidance is coming? And does it really matter if it's a previous soul, like my grandfather, or your grandparents, or a relative that you may never have ever met? Doesn't it matter that it's coming through and that you're recognizing it and saying thank you? So if you find a penny on the ground, pick it up and say thank you. That is source. That is universal energy giving you a sign that you are more open to financial prosperity. Energy doesn't care how many zeros is there or are there. They care if you're grateful or not. I found 3 pennies the other day at Walmart. And it was a sign. I said, wow, 3 of them all in a row. Sometimes you get lucky enough for a nickel, a dime, or a quarter. Pick it up. Say thank you. Put it in your pocket.
Yeah.
And be absolutely in full joy as if it were $1,000 or $10,000. Because as excited you get about a penny, you have to have that to start off with. And then you get more in other ways.
Exactly. I was just telling my brother, he was just here before the show, and I get pennies all the time, but my mom and I started joking, and I started telling her, you know, she would tell me, oh, I've been finding these pennies, and she, you know, she says, and with poverty, you know, going, so about 2 years ago, she said, she knew who they were from, and she says, you know what, with inflation, I would like to start getting dimes. So we both started getting the dimes. And I find dimes all over the place now.
Good for you. I have a wealth bowl, and there are crystals in it. When I first started it, I don't know, maybe 7, 8 years ago, I put a dollar bill in the bottom and covered it with all kinds of crystals, just whatever called to me. And every time I find loose change, I put it in that bowl. I have no idea how much is in there, but man, oh, man. It's multiplying.
My dad collected coins, and right after my another loved one had passed away, I started finding those gold, you know, dollars, the gold dollars in the bottom of my purse. And I knew I didn't have any. I was like, well, how in the heck did they get there? And I started receiving them places I would go. I just went to... Dad was here during the day, and I went down to the service station, and the guy was giving me my change, and he took the singles, and he put them back in the drawer, and he says, for some reason, I feel I'm supposed to give you these. And instead, he gave me the gold dollars back in my change. Those go in my bowl. And believe me, I walk out of there, thank you, thank you, thank you. But I have accumulated quite a few over the last couple of years, and I am very grateful.
All you have to do is start saying thank you, and sometimes things, opportunities, people will be signs of manifestation. And I learned this, I think it was in a book by Florence Scoville Shinn. Last name is spelled S-H-I-N-N. She has several books out. One of them, I'm awful with names and titles, but if you look up Florence Scoville Shinn, she's fabulous. Now, the language is early 40s or early 30s, so if you have an open mind, you'll be able to understand what she's writing about, and it's spot on. She was way ahead of her time, way ahead. And one of the things is that, you know, sometimes it's a sign of manifestation. So if I've asked for more readings, this would be, you 6 to a year ago or so, and someone would call and inquire, but they wouldn't follow through, I would say, thank you for the sign of manifestation. That channel had started to open. What I used to do before that was, well, thanks, guys. Where's my client? I was actually shutting down that pathway or that channel of receiving before it had really gotten clear. So when you're seeing, clones on the ground, or someone calls you up and has a question or is inquiring through email about what you do or how you do it, whether or not that person follows through, it's a sign of manifestation. It's like Christopher Columbus. This is the image they're giving me to help illustrate this more clearly. When Christopher Columbus set out, he was in the middle of the ocean, and then all of a sudden, well, not all of a sudden, but at some point in time, he started seeing, he and the crew, the birds flying, right? They still couldn't see the land, but the birds were a sign of manifestation. And actually before that, there were pieces of wood or dead tree trunks and whatnot floating in the water. So they were getting closer to land. So you give thanks for the signs of manifestation because you're getting closer. You're becoming more aligned, whether it is what it is you want, getting rid of what you don't want, or connecting with source and spirit in whatever way works for you. It's all a matter of being open. If you ask for something, then choose to believe it is either coming, or it's on its way, or it already is. Because everything, and we've learned this from more than one teacher along the way, Abraham Hicks, Doreen Virtue, Wayne Dyer, whomever. Once you ask, it is now available and being held for you in what I call your spiritual escrow account. Now you get to get the you-know-what out of your own way to allow it in. The more specific you are on how it's supposed to show up, you actually limit yourself. You actually limit yourself because, and this is the way that I've been able to help many people understand that if you're working a day job or a night job, and people will often equate that job as to being their source of income. No, it is a channel by which you get paid. The paycheck is a channel of receiving financial prosperity. Several years ago, I was asking for and giving thanks for a certain amount of money. I don't even remember how much it was. And all of a sudden, I got a phone call from First Hawaiian Bank in Hawaii, where I used to work many, many years ago. They had finally tracked me down, and I had in their escrow accounts some kind of employee profit sharing. So I all of a sudden received $3,000 something after they took the taxes out. I could not ever in a million years have manifested that particular channel. I was giving thanks for receiving more of something, and here comes this money. I couldn't have figured that out all by myself if I tried, because once you leave a company, usually what you have in employee profit sharing stays with the company. Well, not mm-hmm. this time. And they've been looking for me for like 10 years.
Wow.
Interesting.
Awesome. Yeah.
I put a couple of quotes from Florence Scoville Shin in the chat room.
Good.
And I think they both work. The game of life is a game of boomerangs. Our thought leads words return to us sooner or later with astounding accuracy.
Yes. Each and every time, without condition, without delay. Well, there's a delay. That's not the right word, guys. Exception, that's the word. Without exception, what you think and believe is exactly what you're going to get. If you don't believe me, look at your life.
Yep. A person knowing the power of word becomes very careful of his conversation. He only has to watch reactions of his words to know that they do not return void. Through his spoken word, man is continually making laws for itself. That's interesting, because it's like when you were saying before, taking a leap of faith, hoping something, not for it, you want it to be.
Into faith.
So it sort of works out. Just that was her first two quotes. Oops.
And this was where she was writing in the 30s or the, you know, way back. Mm-hmm. Before it was popular, and she certainly stepped out of her spiritual closet way back then.
Does anybody have any questions for Terry?
Okay, you can even mic. Okay, hang on. Let's see if we can get Brian. No, I just unmuted you, Goober. Hello, Ryan. Okay, his mic's not working. So, it wasn't my mic all day long. Brian's having computer issues. It don't like him. Okay, Leo, go ahead. Okay, I'm stuck.
You're stuck?
I'm stuck. You know me and my angels, right? I love my angels. I love you. When I first met you, we were so connected with this. The very first angel that you connected with, that you can remember. There was probably times that before that you can remember that you don't remember who or what. But what was the very first connection?
The very first connection, there were no names. It was energy. And I just knew. This is going to sound interesting. When I was first starting the aromatherapy, which was like in 2007-ish or something, the first entity that actually came to me was Isis. And we made her perfume with essential oils, and it was called, she gave me the name, Splendors of Isis. I have always had, yes, I know, an affinity with Isis and Kuan Yin, and so those were the ones that first came because I was more open to them in that way. This is back in the days of the beginning when I was really connecting openly with myself anyway. And it would be another couple of months, and then one afternoon, the angels, they downloaded 15 different recipes, I think it was 15, different essential oil recipes for their specific oils. Mishael, Metatron, Ariel, Haniel, Jeremiel, Jophiel, Raguel, Raziel, Zadkiel, Metatron, Sandolphin, Raguel, Raziel, I may have said a couple of them the same, Uriel, Shamuel, and it was just like boom, 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 and I just started writing them down. It's hard to answer that question, Darlene, because it's so part of my nature. It's not even second nature. It's just all one now. It's hard to remember who came first, really.
Oh, here's Gigi pointed out this out. A lot of Zales in the thing. And I know the answer to this question, but why is it most angels, archangels, names end in the same sound, same letters?
I don't know the answer to that one. I really don't. I do know that not all angel names end in E-L or A-E-L. And if an angel's name, some people have said and written that all angels end with those letters, and if they don't, then they're not angels. That's the information that that person is given, and for that person in that time, that is their truth. Because I have received information about Mishael, Michael, that I haven't ever read or seen or heard from anywhere else, and I would question it. It's like, well, you know, Doreen Virtue, I mean, she's been working with y'all for long time. How come this information isn't in any of my books or in so-and-so's books? And the answer, and it took a long time because I wasn't ready for the answer. And what I was told is everyone's in a different place. They receive energy or messages and guidance at different levels of energy. Again, not better or less than, it's just different. And people's mission, their purpose is slightly different. There are many people, probably thousands, who work with angels, and everybody's information, there are some foundational pieces, or public domain kind of information, all truth, and other bits and pieces come through different people depending upon where they are, what it exactly it is they're here to do, and the messages they are here to deliver. If you don't resonate with someone, you don't resonate. You know, it's as simple as that. If it doesn't click, it doesn't click. Why are they all that way? I don't know. I really don't. Do you have an answer?
I'm trying to find the link.
Gigi says, all archangels end with the E-L suffix, E-L meaning in God, and the first half of the name meaning what each individual angel specializes in. That's from an angel site.
Yeah. That is Gigi's belief, and I honor that. However, there's Sandolphin, and there's also Metatron. They are archangels, and they don't have E-L anywhere in their names.
Okay, Gigi Googled it.
Okay, that is a truth. That is not the only truth. And if whomever chooses to believe that as their only truth, then that is the truth for them. I'm not here to convince anybody of anything, but Metatron and Sandolphin do not have EL in their names. That doesn't make them any less archangels than anybody else. We all have different vibrations at which we accept. One of my teachers, Master Ko, says it's like understanding that there are seven major energy centers, the seven chakras. When in a different reality or a different level of understanding, there are many more. So it's not throwing out the first level of understanding. It's about adding to it if you so choose. If for this beautiful soul, Gigi and others, only archangels have EL in them, then that's her truth. That doesn't offend me or the angels in any way. That's her truth. Okay.
Yeah. She was just mentioning it, and I picked up on it. And what she found, she did a Google search. It wasn't because
she just checked it out.
Okay. I misunderstood. So I'm not trying to pick on her, but it's you know, different people get different information. That's all.
And Scott, I'm not sure if he Googled this either. The EL stands for God, Lord, Power in Hebrew. It is most commonly read as either of God or God is in the names. But there are many different and other semantic possibilities too. LOL, me too. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, okay, he Googled it too.
He Googled it too, that is. Yeah. But, yeah, no, everybody has a different thing. It's the same thing. This is what I heard was that, and I asked the same question a while back, why is it that EL or IL isn't? And they said, well, it's because, those are the angels that are connected to God and yada, yada, yada. And I was like, but there are others, you know, it's don't have the EL and the IL.
Corrine has a question in the chat room. She says, how much can angels help humanity, and are they allowed to?
Angels are allowed to help when they are asked. Guardian angels have a little more latitude because they are yours. Archangel Michael, Raphael, and all the other archangels are not guardian angels. They may be extra protectors, but they're not your personal guardian angels. Guardian angels are only to Mama D. Jennifer has her own, and I have my own, as each person on this earth has their own. Can they help humanity? When asked. Provided it's not going against someone else's desires. So my dad cannot manifest something differently for me than what I choose to have in my life. He can help me manifest what I am wanting to manifest, but he cannot, if he wants me to drive a certain kind of car, he cannot manifest that I drive car XYZ when I want LMNOP. Doesn't work that way because it goes against my free choice and my free will. Angels will not interfere. They will not intervene in that way. So if someone wants to have so-and-so fall in love with them, not going to happen. If someone wants Johnny's job, not going to happen because that's manifesting someone out of their good, their free will, and their choice. What you can manifest is someone like so-and-so or manifest a position like Johnny's or manifest that position for yourself without trying to get rid of someone else. Angels can help humanity. Yes, absolutely. Humanity must ask because we've been given free will and free choice, and they're not allowed to intervene under any circumstances except if your life is in grave danger and it's not your time to go. That is the only time they are allowed to interfere without being asked.
Wow. I've got a, well, I don't know. No question is silly, but years ago, and this was when I first, you know, I knew that the angels were coming in. I was starting to see them, but somebody had told me, and then I had read it somewhere, that usually when you first start seeing the angels, you would see them in a triangle shape. And have you ever heard that?
No, but again, that is a truth for that person and doesn't make it right or wrong. I don't see colors of an aura like other people do. I sense it through energy. The angels tell me through the energy what colors they are. And I know by the energy signature who it is, if they're popping in and telling me their name. Most often now, especially with the ones who we work together so closely, I just know who it is. And then when I'm journaling, if I have a question, I say, is this so-and-so? And they say, yes. Or they'll just come out and say it. But I most often know by the energy. My primary gift, if you will, yes, thank you, is through energy, and I'm actually being reminded that it's energy and hearing. So those two are my top two, with seeing being very close, and then that sense of knowing is at the bottom for me. When you develop any of the four primary psychic gifts, talents, or gifts, however you want to say them, you actually bring the others up. So, yeah, this is not always easy. So if you can see my hand, so if your sensing through energy is here and your sense of claircognizance is there, as you raise your level of sensing through energy, everything rises together. So you're not leaving one of your senses or your gifts behind. It's coming up at the same level of interval. Does that make any sense, or am I just totally losing
everybody?
No, that
makes sense.
No,
well,
it makes sense.
Good.
Yay,
it's always easier when you can see. Always easier when you can see hands.
Yeah, and I just figured, well, I figured when I saw that and then I heard it, I thought, well, because it was just that week, my grandson was a little bit younger. Like I said, this was some years ago. And I know he had told other people that he had seen things in the house, and he gets up one morning and he jumps up on the couch and sits next to me and says, Grandma, I saw two angels last night again. And I'm like, oh, really? And he says, yeah, and I know I can tell you because you believe me. And I said, well, how do you know for a fact that they were angels? And he says, well, they were yellow in color and they were in a triangle shape. And I'm like, well, lo and behold. And then, like I said, later on that week, I heard it, and then I actually had read it, that a lot of times they would come through in a triangle shape. And I'm thinking, that's just to validate what my grandson said. But I've heard a few other people say that they've seen them in a triangle shape.
Here's the thing about angles another way, ladies and gentlemen. The angels will come through in ways that you will understand.
Yes.
And recognize. So a rainbow for me means one thing, and it could mean something entirely different to Mama D and something entirely beyond that for Jennifer.
Yeah.
What matters is when you ask, remember to say at the end, in a way I easily understand and recognize. Because if you don't, and they're speaking Latin, and you don't get Latin, you're going to miss it all day long. Mm-hmm. You're not going to connect. So if you're hearing them, or you think you are, and the volume's low, ask them to turn up the volume.
Right.
Ask them to connect with you in ways that you easily understand and recognize. For Jennifer and her grandson, it's through triangles. For other people, it's through triangles. For other people, it's feathers of certain colors. Does it really matter? It's not right or wrong. It's what works for you.
Yeah, I see them in all different, I see them in many different ways, but I just thought that very interesting when he had said the triangles. Yes, and I get many signs. I do recognize all my signs. I pay attention. And I know that my life is very synchronistic. Not a day goes by that I don't get my synchronicities and my signs. And I am grateful. And I do say thank you.
The more you say thank you, and the more you are aware, the more people think it's being given, but the truth is the more that you recognize, because it's always being given.
Oh, the animals that come, every sign, I am grateful and I do say thank you. I know I'm very blessed for having these abilities to recognize.
Terry, you used to do readings. Do you still do readings for people? Call you up?
On
do you
occasion.
Still have clients?
On occasion.
If something, because I took a quick look at your website, and there are no spaces. So if somebody wanted to contact you and say, I would like a reading, would they contact you through Facebook or your website?
Either one is fine. You're welcome to contact me directly at Terry Marie, that's T-E-R-R-I-E, Marie, at angeldreamteam.com, through Facebook. There's a contact button on my website, I believe, somewhere.
Yes, there
so,
is.
So, okay. Yeah. You can tell how much I pay attention to that part. I'm doing other things and, posting articles or trying to. You are welcome to join us in the Facebook group, Angels for Success and Prosperity. Just ask to join, and you're in. It's pretty much that simple. Try to make it easy for people. Now, I don't do readings very often anymore because I'm guided to do deeper work. It's about the blind spots and helping people to raise their own vibration so that they can take care of themselves. A reading is a temporary fix. It's fine. There's lots of people doing it. I just happen to be guided away from it. If someone really wants it, we'll talk about it.
Mm-hmm. Copy. I lost the link. Oops. Jennifer got it.
Aha. Yeah.
Okay. Hang on a second. You've also said that you see auras, but you don't see auras as color. You're kind of sort of told, guided to the color and the connection that you have.
Mm-hmm.
If you notice somebody you work with daily or you see every other day or something, and their aura is sort of like a little bit out of whack, okay, would you be the type of person who often say, you gotta kind of, I'm not, not saying what is it, the Long Island medium type of thing, but, it's somebody, example, if you and I actually work side by side, would you go up to the person and say, you know, this is what I see, this is what I feel?
Only, no, unless if it's someone that I know and that we're comfortable with each other on a personal level, yes. And even then, beautiful, there are things that I'm being told that I am told, and I'm not sure why I am, that I'm not allowed to share. And okay. it's more of a, when I was doing readings regularly years ago, in first stages of practicing actually, because when you first tap into that, or at least for me, from my personal experience, it was, okay, I have no idea where this stuff is coming from. Am I, you know, just talking out of the side of my face or the back of my head? Or is this really helping someone? Am I really intuiting it and receiving it, channeling it from spirit and angels? Or am I just making crap up? And this one woman who we were just becoming friends, and you, without really divulging the confidence, she probably will never hear this or see it, but that's not the point. Mm-hmm. She wanted a reading, and she didn't ask any questions out loud. They were just in her head, which made it even more of a challenge because I didn't have anything to go off on, which is okay. Some people don't want to give their stuff away because some psychics, some mediums just read off of what people tell them rather than really intuiting information. And anyway, it was about someone that she really loved. Here's the kicker. The guy she loved was married to someone else, and she too is married to someone else. And she wanted to know, you know, something came up, and it was like, okay, and I knew she was married, but the person coming into the reading was not the guy she was married to. And she said, yeah, there was someone, and would they ever be together? I don't know that she ever asked that question out loud, but I was told they would never, ever be together. And this is 10 years later, and they are not together. They're still married to their separate spouse, you know, their respective spouses.
Mm-hmm.
I was never allowed to tell her that. She never came out and asked me, that I'm aware of, would they ever get together? She asked questions around that, which I was allowed to answer. And there are times when people think they want the answer, and they don't.
Yeah, true.
Exactly. So true.
Answer your question. I'm not sure.
No, it does. It does. Supernatural video. Supergirl, Corrine in the chat room. I've got so many names for this child. Can Terry answer, how exactly have angels helped you in your life?
Well, the party line is they help me in every way, and that's the truth. With, let's see, the most recent experience was a health issue at the end of July. All of a sudden, one Saturday evening, I had this incredible massive pain, and it turned out to be gallbladder. It was major surgery, so in less than 4 days, 5 days, I was back at home. And every single day, well, while I was, I had no, at the time, no insurance because it's expensive. And working by yourself, you know, there's no employer to pay it. And $600 a month was not something that I could easily have afforded at the time. That's half of my monthly rent. Well, I prefer to live in a house and not on the street. Thank you very much. Mm-hmm. So how did the angels help me in this situation? When it was apparent that I had no choice except to go to the emergency room, once I accepted that and the pain was managed to where I could actually connect, my parents and I, bless their hearts, 85 and 86 at the time, now both 86 and 87, we held hands as we often do, and I just said a prayer out loud. I also started posting on my Facebook page, Help for Healing, because I knew I couldn't do it by myself. They were pumping drugs into my body. I don't do them, don't have any medications. I hardly ever take any aspirin or Tylenol, whatever you want to call it. So this stuff was foreign to me. I knew it was screwing with my vibration. Even in that drug-induced state for me, I knew that somehow the hospital bills would be taken care of. How? Dunno. What ended up happening is the hospital gave an 85% discount, and every other medical bill is being paid on a monthly installment plan. And most of them, I think 80% of them, because everything's a la carte, everything. Have a tissue, oh, that's $100. I'm being a little facetious, but it's close to that. Every other medical payment, 80% of them, have been reduced between 20 and 85%. There's no way I would have been able to figure that out by myself or have the belief for it to come out. Now, did a girlfriend suggest to me that that could happen? Yes. Had I not had the faith and that absolute undeniable knowing that somehow it would be okay, that information would not have been made available to me. Angels will get you the message. They will get you the information one way or another. All you have to do is be open. The angels made sure I had enough cash to take with me to the Tucson Gem and Mineral Show. After all, this part of the expansion is their idea. I love crystals, but I had stopped selling them and getting them for 6 years. They helped me write the emails. They helped me with the live trainings. Jennifer, you and Mama D, maybe you've seen some of them. You probably know that there's no script. All I'm given is the title for the talk, and that's it.
Right.
And we channel the rest right then and there. They help me every single step and breath of the way. They absolutely do, because I allow it, I encourage it, and I ask for it. So, okay, what are we teaching today?
Yeah.
So Corinne, so basically you're saying that the angels helped you manifest.
Mm-hmm.
In this circumstance.
They helped me manifest and helped me heal my body. Within 3 weeks of being released from the hospital, I was back at the El Paso Psychic Fair giving readings. So that's the one place, you know, I do that about 5 or 6 times a year. So that's my way of giving to the community and connecting with people face to face. Otherwise, it's pretty much around the world in this kind of a setting. But I was there 3 weeks. Now, I was not at full pace, okay? But I was back, and I was giving readings and being of service within 3 weeks of major surgery.
I truly believe that you can ask for the help and get it to.
Say again, Jennifer?
I said I am a firm believer in asking the angels for help and receiving, because I have many a times, I'm not going to say $3,000 got dropped into my bank account, but that's going to happen too. But yes, I mean, there were many a times, I just had to say, hey, you know what? Angels, I need help. You know, please. And I had a nice talk with the angels, and everything worked out. And I just knew it was going to. You know, you can't sit and worry about it.
Okay.
Oh my gosh, Jackie. Here's
down in the West Texas of town of El Paso, I fell in love with a Mexican girl. Now that's in your head too.
Remember, that means something very significant to me, Jackie. Yee. Okay, here we go.
Okay. I have a question. Now, you're very, and I love you for this, and do you ever get doubts? Because people are out there going, my God, she just believes it all, and it's like, I know, okay, but do you ever get doubts? And when you do, when you get a doubt, what, you know, how do you work it past?
One of the gifts, if you want to call it that, of being human is you do experience different kinds of feelings and emotions, and some of them are fear and doubt, and there's confusion. It's like, well, am I really getting this information, or is it just, you know, I'm making crap up? They wanted to say the S word, but I sometimes get to choose not to say that. You know? When they're really
I swear, Darryl, for you.
You know, there have been times, and there are going to be other times, when we go to up level. And by up level, I mean taking that next step in your journey, whether it is up the corporate ladder, whether it's promotion, whether it's going out on your own, whether it's working full time and starting your spiritual business or healing practice on the side. That's what I did for years. And then going full time. Of course, you know, sometimes we get shoved into it when we don't want to. However, are there doubts? Absolutely. What do I do? Depends on the level or the intensity of the doubt. For example, when I was working on staying out of my own way and letting go of the outcome for the $3,000 for my Tucson General Show budget, and there, I think like end of December, I wasn't sure I was going to have it. And we're talking, we're 30 days out now, and I'm seeing some of it. And what I did was I wrote a letter. I'm a firm believer in writing it, not just saying it, not just thinking it, because thinking and saying only involves part of you. When you are writing, you are engaging all of you. We are in physical form. Therefore, when we do things physically, we, especially like writing, we're involving our emotions, our thought, our energy, and our physical self. You are focusing everything into what you're writing. So you are then channeling negative energy, just like when you are being grateful. That's positive energy. You're channeling the negative energy into this letter. So I would, you know, dear beloved angels, or dear Terry Marie, or hello, you know, whatever. It's like, and you say out what you're afraid of. What is it you're doubting? You say, hey, you know, like what? Yeah, it's just when you are afraid of something, you face the lion on your path and you write it out, literally. This is not the time to rephrase it to be positive and upbeat. Never mind that BS. Say what you need to say. Get it the hell out from inside, because if you don't, you block your throat chakra, you block your solar plexus, and you gum up, G-U-M, gum up your heart center. So I say, you know, it looks like, and I'm afraid I'm not going to have the money that I want. And so I said some other things, and I just sit down and I channel it out. I just let it out. And then towards the end, I start rewriting what is a real truth. I have this. I'm just getting out of my own way because it's already in my spiritual escrow account. I'm just getting the hell out of the way to allow it in. How? I don't know. I was supposed to take $2,600 in cash, and I decided I would take $2,500 and the rest of it go on my debit card for the hotel. Well, Thursday before I was to leave, someone I had met the previous Monday called up and say, hey, you know, do you have a chance for a reading? And I went, sure. I had blocked a whole day to get ready for the trip, and it just so happened at 3:15 in the afternoon on Thursday the 26th, this guy calls up and said, la, la, la. He gave me the extra $100 that I was supposed to take. Now, I was going to set it aside, and I kept getting the feeling, no, take it with you. So I did. Getting back to the letter, when I'm done with it, I say to myself, I love you, I love me, I love myself, and I forgive me. What I'm forgiving myself for is having doubted that it was actually going to be there when I needed it. I didn't need it at the end of December. I needed it on the 26th of January to go to the bank to get it out. Have it. I had it. When you finish writing the letter, and you can write it for various things like an argument between you and a friend or your loved ones, things that you can't really say to someone's face because no matter how you try to word it, it's going to backfire and bite you in the back end. So you do it this way to clear out the energy. So, you know, dear so-and-so, this is how I felt. This is what it made me feel. This is la, 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 and this is what I need to say to you. And at the end, I love you. I forgive you. This is forgiveness, and it's unconditional love. And then you say also, writing, I love myself and I forgive myself. You do not need to, and please don't, list everything you're forgiving so-and-so for or you, because then you're just focusing on the crap you just let go of. When you're done with the letter, burn it or tear it up into little pieces, the ashes or the pieces you put into the garden or in the rubbish bin. Do not recycle. You're going to recycle the energy. When you do this and you're honest with yourself and you're really letting it go, you will feel a sense of your energy lifting and the burden becoming less. If you need to write the letter again about the same thing, do it. Do it. When you watch it go up in smoke, you're seeing the energy dissipate. You're seeing it dissolve. You're giving it over to Source, your power animals, the spirit guides, ascended masters, to your angels. You're letting it go. You're getting it out from the inside. I also do that when I want to bring something in, but I do it mostly for letting go, because you really have to get it out, whatever it is.
I have the same. I do the same exact thing. I go out there and burn it. And then when I am asking, usually for, you know, the full moons, I go out there. When I'm asking the universe for something, I will write it all down, and then I will go out there and, okay, it's burn it off to the universe. I've asked, and I'm thankful, you know, grateful for it. But, yeah, I've got the same. I burn it. Diane says, yes, I finally forgave myself the other night and was told last night I now need to write a thank you letter. And that's a very good idea. Very good idea.
And you can burn that thank you as well.
Yes.
People often think, if, especially on our spiritual path, that if we name a number that we want to earn, that we're painting ourselves in a box. And so sometimes people say, well, I want to earn $3 million. I said, well, how likely is that to happen for you? Now, here's what I'm not saying, that I don't believe they can get there. But if they're earning, say, $30,000 a year, that $3 million is so far that they're not able to bridge that gap energetically. So I suggest that they pick a different number, and, you know, one that's still a stretch. So if they're making $30,000 a year, maybe they want to double it, which is significant. I say, when you get to 60, give yourself a pay raise. Oh, because it's not about painting anyone in a box. The stretch needs to be believable, but beyond what you're doing, but not so far that it's so far out in the horizon. It's like, yeah, that's never going to happen, so you never try. Mm-hmm. Don't make things so freaking complicated. Keep it simple. You know, kiss it. Keep it simple, sweetie. I know there's another word, but I choose that one.
I like that, yeah. And keep it freaking simple, too.
Exactly. Yeah. Humans make everything really super hard because that's what we're taught. We're taught through fear. Look both ways before crossing the street. Well, that one's still pretty good. Don't talk to strangers. Well, when you're little, that's a good one. But now you're grown. How many people do you actually look in the eye and either smile or say hello?
Oh, yeah.
I've been going to the same gym for a year now, and hardly anybody looks me in the eye. It's like, okay, whatever. Don't talk to strangers. What do you think I want? Your left pinky or something? I don't. I'm just saying hello.
Right.
But it's the truth. Look at people even in the coffee shop. Oh, don't look at me. I'm busy. I'm busy. Don't look at me.
Yeah.
Right? We're afraid to acknowledge each other. And what is it we crave most in this technological world? One-on-one, face-to-face connection. And yet that's one of the things that we're so afraid of. Well, what if they know of my stuff? Okay. What if they know your stuff? And I share my stuff a lot.
Right. I have noticed, well, I'm avoiding, you know, going out too much to the store. You know, there's been a lot of negative energy out there. But I have, you know, noticed that if I go into the store and it's not really crowded and there's this, you know, at least every visit, I get somebody that will walk by me and look me dead in the eye, and you just, I start feeling things. I think that's pretty awesome. And it's like, you know I was here to experience that. But, yeah, a lot of people are like, don't talk to me. Don't look at me. I want nothing to do with you. Oh, yes. Corrine loves talking to strangers.
She talks to us.
Yeah, but she does.
Most people will avoid talking to someone they don't know.
Not Corrine. And people are drawn. You know, people are drawn to Corrine. People are drawn because they recognize that. And that's, like I said, with some of the people that I've encountered, they recognize that light in you. I know that. They recognize that light in you. Not everybody does. But, yes, Corrine does, you know, attract a lot of people's attention.
And sometimes the light will blind others to you, because their energy is so different, they absolutely cannot see you because you are too bright.
Yeah. And some people can't handle the light of you. Yeah, that's true.
That's right.
I know.
That's exactly right.
I've just recently had somebody telling me, I mean, every time he's around, no matter where we're at together, where we bump in, he comes here, if I'm over there, he has, you know, now he is admitting, you know, every time I'm around, the craziest stuff starts happening. Before, he would avoid it, you know, you could tell, but he's starting to recognize that and starting to be more open about it.
Leo, thankfully I found that in Canada, sometimes people will strike up a conversation with another, strangers obviously, more in smaller towns and cities than large metropolises. But in Europe, it was so much different. People are so open, and even in the bigger cities. That's true. Leo went on a little trip to the UK and Europe, and he met a lot of nice people.
Yeah, different.
London, Sweden, and Denmark. I know London was a trip. That's how I got to know Leo. Okay, well, it is 8:28. We're going to cut it for now because, Terry, you've been talking for 2 hours pretty much nonstop. So I need to thank you. Yeah, the Aussies are okay, too. I need to thank you, Terry, for showing up and giving us your...
We're all echoing.
Yes, you share. It's what I love about you. You always, always share. There is just nothing that you don't mind sharing.
Nope.
Yeah. Nope. Thank you so much. And I do suggest that everybody go over and join the Angels for Success and, see how it resonates with you. But I thank you so much, Terry Marie, and this is going to be awesome. And I really look forward to, you know, taking advantage of all your offering on the Angels for Success.
You're both welcome, and everyone who joined us this evening or going to be watching at some point in time, thank you for your time, your energy, your questions, and for joining. Without you, the energy would not have been the same. And should we have a conversation at some point in the future with some of the same questions, the energy will be different and the answers may be slightly different because, as always, the angels will tailor to whoever shows up.
Well, like Gigi says, I hope you do come back, Terry. And you can always come back as kids in the chat room. A little note for next week, everybody. It is, amongst other things, it's a show that we're going to have open and free conversation. And there's at least two people in the chat room who better be here with their poetry in hand. That would be Leo and my little Supergirl. Because next week, poetry. So, Terry, if you have any poetry, you can come along and read some poetry and share your words, poetic prose. I think that's it for the night. Thank you, everybody. It's been another awesome week, and I will see you all next week. Much love and light.
Thank you all for being here. Thank you again, Terry Marie.
You're welcome. My pleasure. Our pleasure. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.